listen to me, Ben. You know what I've said about your God is true.
No, everything you've said is nothing but lies.
Why are you so afraid of the truth? Why don't you acknowledge my power, Ben, and you can have it too?
No.
Pray, Ben.
No.
In the name of Jesus, pray.
Why do you deny it? You want my power.
No. Greater is he who is in me than he who is in the world.
No power is greater than my power, you simpering fool. Don't you see that? I'll show you. I'll show you how great my power is. I command you to...
In the name of Jesus, be still!
No!
In the name of Jesus!
Stop!
In the name of Jesus!
Stop!
In the name of Jesus!
Stop! Stop!
In the name of Jesus!
Jesus!
Courtney, I am trying to explain.
There's nothing to explain.
Well, I think there is. Now, I decided to represent Tina in her paternity suit against Vaughn because of you.
Me?
Yes. I mean, I thought you would enjoy seeing Vaughn get his in court after what happened in the annulment hearing.
You couldn't possibly think that he's the father of her child.
It doesn't matter what I think. Tina is claiming he's the father, and that's what counts. It'll be up to a judge to decide.
I don't want you to have anything to do with her.
But look, I think we ought to stick it to Vaughn now.
Not this way.
Why?
Because.
Yeah, well, that's not good enough.
Dan, I would be embarrassed to have all this come up again.
Embarrassed? I would think that would be impossible after all the embarrassment he's already caused you.
I don't care. Let her get another lawyer.
Look, I don't understand why you are so upset about this.
It doesn't matter. I don't want you to represent Tina in court. It's as simple as that.
Glad you're here. I got a couple of things I want to go over with you.
Preston, I just met Gil Prescott at the Greenbrier restaurant.
Huh?
Now, Gil informs me that you instructed him to begin construction of the docks instead of the warehouses. Now, is that true?
It is. That's one of the things I want to talk to you about.
Preston, I don't understand. Why the change?
Well, I thought we'd come out ahead if we started the docks before winter set in.
You thought... Preston, we had agreed that construction of those docks would begin in early spring because of weather.
Now, look, I think I have a little more knowledge about this than you
do. Save it, will you, Preston? I think there's something here that you're not admitting.
Like what?
I don't know. Suppose you tell me.
Well, Vaughn, we're a shipping company. I thought it would be good for community relations if they saw us construct docks first.
Community relations?
Yes.
But this is going to drive the cost way up.
No. We get started within the next 2 weeks. We're going to come out way ahead.
Preston, how do you figure that?
Well, we'll be ready for complete operations as early as March next year.
But you're forgetting the warehouses.
Huh?
We were supposed to use them to store the equipment and material for the dock construction. That was where we were going to save the money.
Ah, now you're interested in business again, huh? Good, good. For a while, I thought all you were concerned about was Courtney and religion. Religion and Courtney.
Preston, they are still both very important to me.
All right.
As a matter of fact, did Courtney get in touch with you today?
No, why?
Well, she stopped by the office to see you, of course. And I informed her that she could file for divorce.
You what?
Surprised?
Surprised? Just lately, you were telling me in my office how you were patiently going to wait for her. Now you're telling me you're going to let her have a divorce?
Preston, I've just realized that I've been loving Courtney selfishly. You can't love someone like that. Not truly love them.
So you really do want to give up on her?
Preston, there's not that much left to give up. I'm just facing reality. Now, I know you don't understand that, because to you, love means holding on.
If the wife I loved were in the arms of a man like Dan Myers, you bet I'd hold on.
Preston, as much as I hate to see her with him, I can't stop her.
I'm glad you're able to join me, Miss Parker.
Betty, please.
Short for Elizabeth, right?
Yes, why?
Oh, I was just curious. You're a member of the Responsible Citizens Movement.
Yes, as a matter of fact, I'm its attorney.
I know.
Why do you want to interview me? After all, Frank Talbot is the man to talk to. He's our PR man.
Well, I've actually had my fill of PR people. If I wanted the glowing details of the Responsible Citizens Movement, I could have gotten that from your literature. Mm. What I'm after is the inside story.
What's that?
Well, you tell me.
Just what are you leading to, Miss Phillips?
Why did your group ask my father to run for Congress?
He's the best man for the job, I'm sure you agree.
Well, of course I do. But my father has no previous political experience.
We felt he would make an excellent congressman.
And that's why you're pushing to have him included in the TV debate. A debate that was originally between the two frontrunners, Wainwright and Carruthers.
That's right. I'm sure you kept up with the polls. Your father is a very serious contender now, and we feel that he deserves equal access with the other two.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure that Lee Carruthers would agree with that entirely.
What do you mean by that?
Well, it just seems to me that your group's support of my father's candidacy is actually a move against Hugh Wainwright, and that would help Lee Carruthers. Isn't that true?
No.
Then your group is against Lee Carruthers' candidacy.
Well, I didn't say that.
Well, then what exactly are you saying?
Our group is fully behind your father. We believe he's the best choice, as I've said.
Then where does your group stand in regards to Lee Carruthers' campaign?
We're not supporting him.
Then you're opposed to Lee Carruthers and what he stands for.
That's another way of saying it, yes.
Do you know Lee Carruthers personally?
Now, why would you ask that?
Oh, I'm just curious. Do you?
No.
Have you ever met him?
Well, perhaps I've seen him at some social function, but no, I've never met him face to face.
Is that right?
Oh, yes.
And how do you explain that?
Courtney, would you try to be reasonable about this?
I don't have to be reasonable when it comes to Tina Brubaker.
Why do you hate her so much?
Do you have to ask? You of all people should know the answer to that after what she did to me at the annulment hearing.
All right, so she's in love with Vaughn. Okay, why should that bother you?
It just does.
Courtney, forget about Tina and Vaughn. Just think about us.
I don't want you involved with her.
As her attorney, I won't be involved with her. Not the way you mean.
Oh, yeah? Look at what happened to us.
That's completely different. You are special to me.
And what about Tina? Don't you think she's pretty?
Yeah, I guess she's... Oh, come. Are you jealous? You are, aren't you?
If you are thinking that I forgot about that little fling that you two had, think again.
Courtney, that's ancient history. I mean, I've forgotten all about it. And I wish you would, too, because it doesn't mean a thing. You are the only woman for me.
Am I?
You know it.
Then drop Tina.
Courtney, this is a professional matter. You have to understand that. You can't just go ordering me around to drop a client.
And you can't expect me to accept your traipsing around with a tramp.
It'll be strictly business, I promise.
She'll find a way to make it more than that. Look at the way she snared Vaughn.
Who cares about Vaughn? Who cares about anybody but us? Courtney, listen. This paternity suit is not even going to take that much time, I promise you. I mean, it'll be over before we know it.
Just like our relationship.
Are you telling me that...
Yes, I am.
Look, I've already told her I'm going to represent her. That's it.
Then tell her that you've changed your mind.
Courtney, you know me. I don't like being ordered around like some kind of servant.
Oh, Dad, you're not a servant. I just don't want you to represent Tina in court. It's a very simple choice.
And what if I decide to keep her as a client?
Then we're through. It's up to you, Dan. See, now I think that you should go to Tina's dorm room and tell her to get another lawyer. So what's it going to be? Is she dead?
I don't know.
Is she?
Yes, she is. It's all over, Nancy. It's all over. It's okay.
My legs. I can feel my legs again.
It's okay. Ben, what happened?
She's dead, Brian. She's dead.
It looks like a massive cerebral hemorrhage. Are you all right, Ben? Ben?
Huh? Yes. Yes, I am.
It was like nothing I've ever seen before in real life.
What do you mean by that?
Well, it was just so frightening.
What is she talking about?
I'm not all that sure myself.
Ben, your hand. It's okay.
Yeah. When Vanessa died, it returned to normal.
Just what went on here?
Ryan, it was so weird.
Well, at least you're all right. Lori will be glad to know that.
Lori?
Yeah, I stopped past your house and told her you were coming over here. I know you're probably angry, but I had to.
What did she say?
She was upset. I thought she was going to come over here.
Ben, you know, she probably prayed for us.
Why did you come?
I came because I wanted to help you.
There was only one thing that helped. One name.
I don't understand.
I'll explain it all to you later.
All right. Now, what do you say we get out of here?
Oh, yes. Let's.
Ben, you don't want to stay here.
Oh, come on, Ben. This place is creepy.
No, you two go on. I have to think. I just want some time.
Is your car here?
No, Vanessa brought me here. Could you take me to Ione's?
Sure thing. Come on, Ben. Let me drive you home.
No, I do. I need to stay here and just think this thing through. Nancy, are you going to be all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. My legs are great. Ben, I don't know what I would have done if you hadn't come.
It wasn't me.
Well, yes, Ben, it was.
No, Nancy, it wasn't me.
Car, are you ready?
Yeah.
You're sure you want to stay here?
Yeah, I'll be fine. I'm going to follow the ambulance. I want to find out what the autopsy says.
Come on, Nancy. Let me drive you over to Ione's.
Okay.
Look, you call Lori, and you let her know you're all right.
Dear Lord, thank you. Forgive me.
It looks to me like you and Congressman Carruthers are very friendly. Well, we must have met at some function or other. I just don't recall that.
You expect me to believe that?
Let me explain something. I think there's a connection between the Responsible Citizens Movement and Lee Carruthers. In fact, I think Lee Carruthers is using my father to upset Wainwright's campaign.
I don't know anything about that.
Oh, no? Well, I'm going to get to the bottom of this, and when I do, those who are involved are going to have a lot of explaining to do.
Miss Phillips, what do you want from me?
The truth?
Are you, willing to make a deal?
Not if that includes hiding the truth.
Oh, it won't. I just want to protect myself from the storm that's going to come when your story appears.
Well, I'll do what I can to help you, but I need to know what you know.
Well, first of all, I want you to know that the Responsible Citizens Movement started with the best of intentions. Later, Lee got involved secretly and, well, he started manipulating the group's decisions behind the scenes.
Well, what about this campaign?
Well, I want to go on record that I had no idea what Lee was up to at first. But you're right. Lee wanted RCM to support your father in order to take away votes from Wainwright.
I knew it.
And that picture, that was taken at a fundraiser a couple of years ago. I thought that Lee and I could, well, nothing happened, but anyway, I admit that Lee is behind your father's campaign. But how did you know I was involved?
I saw your initials on the upper corner of the checks from your group.
Yes, that's why you asked if Betty was short for Elizabeth.
Yes.
Well, actually, I'm rather glad this whole thing's over. I hope you'll wait a couple of days before you break your story. I need some time to get some things together.
I promise.
Thanks.
Quite honestly, I need the time myself. Not only to do some more research, but to figure out how to tell my father about all this.
Excuse me.
Vaughn, telling Courtney she could have a divorce wasn't smart.
Preston, it was the only thing to do.
Look, she's only going to look at that as a sign of weakness.
It took more strength than I knew I had.
Look, I don't understand you lately.
Look, I know you don't, okay? So let's just drop.
But why are you caving in like this?
I just told you. Because I love her.
Oh, that's nonsense. You love somebody, you fight for them. Besides, this new religious concept of yours, aren't they opposed to divorce?
Yes, of course they are. But they're also for love. Love that tries to consider the other before yourself. That is what I'm trying to do here.
Oh, that's cute. That's cute. Now, what do you hope to gain from all of this?
Preston, I don't think like that anymore. I'm more interested in giving than taking and receiving. Look, she left me, Preston. She's the one who wants this divorce. Now, if she wants to be free of me, I cannot stop her.
Well, to me, you're just giving up.
Look, Preston, I have tried blackmail. I have tried coercion. And all it has done is bred hatred and resentment. Well, I am through with all of that. I just realized that God loves me unconditionally. Well, that's what I'm trying to do where Courtney is concerned.
Well, maybe she'll understand that kind of logic, but I don't.
Preston, how can I make you realize that you can't force someone to love you? I mean, can't you see that's why all your plans for Courtney have failed?
Oh, now we get around to me, huh? I'm not a good father.
No, Preston, just look at what you did. You tried to get Courtney to marry me by blackmailing her emotionally.
I did what I had to do.
Did you?
Yes.
Preston, you know very well that you used Phyllis's medical care as a bargaining block to bring her around to your way of thinking.
And you?
Well, I was wrong, too. I tried to use my family's wealth. Her mother's sickness was the only thing that kept her with me. Well, I am ashamed of that.
Vaughn, we all, Courtney included, did what we thought was right at the time.
And I am doing what I think is right at this time.
Back so soon?
We have to talk. There's going to be a slight change in our plans.
What kind of change?
I don't think it would be very wise for me to represent you.
Oh? Courtney make your mind up for you? Does she do that a lot?
Now, you listen
to me. No, you listen. Now, either you represent me in this paternity suit,
or I go to Courtney and tell her that you're the father of the
baby. Just hear me out, Tina. Courtney is adamant. She doesn't want me on the case.
I don't care.
Look, I am not going to ruin my relationship with Courtney because of you.
Me and your baby.
What I'm going to do is get you another attorney.
What?
That's right. I'm going to hire another good lawyer. He'll handle the case. I'll take care of the fees. It won't cost you a cent.
Dan, I don't want another lawyer. This is your responsibility.
Would you stop saying that?
Why? It is your responsibility. You are the father, and don't you ever forget that.
It might be my child, but as far as I'm concerned, it's your problem, Tina. And if I were you, sweetheart, I would get an abortion.
No! I am going to have this baby, and I am going to love it and care for it, even if you are the father.